When we are projection mapping with QLab, there is one important thing that we need to take into consideration, which is the desired resolution of the surface that we want to projection map. Today, I'm going to show you how to calculate this resolution for both simple and complex surfaces so your projection design will look the way it is supposed to. Say we want to projection map onto this square shape. In QLab, we can go ahead and create a surface with the display assigned to it. Next, we proceed with the usual corner pinning. Now, if we were to assign an image of a circle and show it on that surface, we would expect it to, well, look like a circle. But as we can see, that's not what the case is. What is happening here is we are taking a rectangular aspect ratio and we're trying to cram it into a square. And when you do this, it takes our otherwise perfect circle and squeezes it inwards, distorting it. The way we are going to solve this issue is by calculating the proper resolution for our surface size. This is done independently of your content and at the QLab level. Let's start off with a simple example. The first thing we need to know are the dimensions of the surface that we are going to be projecting on. My square projection surface is 11 inches by 11 inches. Since the width and the height of the surface are the same, the number of pixels for the height and for the width also needs to be the same. We could arbitrarily choose a resolution, say, of 100 by 100 pixels or 1 million by 1 million pixels. If the number is too low, the image will be very pixelated, and if the number is too big, we will be wasting much of our computer's compute power. So, we need to find a sweet spot that is just right. By and large, most projectors output a resolution of 1920 by 1080, so it would not make much sense to create a surface with a higher resolution than the projector can output in the first place. If we were to draw out our projector's output, we can see that we can fit our square inside of it. If we were to overlay the dimensions, we would find that our surface resolution at maximum could be 1080 by 1080 pixels. However, in this case, I would most likely round down to 1,000 by 1,000 pixels, since we hardly ever line up the projector's output to the surface exactly in practice. Now let's look at a surface where the width and the height are different. This rectangle measures 11 inches wide by 14 inches tall. Once again, we can draw our projector's output and put our surface inside of it. We can pretty easily see that the height of the surface will be 1080 pixels once again. However, it is not immediately apparent what the width should be. To get this number, we need to find the ratio between the height and the width of the surface. To do this, we need to take the width of the surface and divide it by the height, which will equal 0.78. Now, we can take the number of pixels we found for the height and multiply it by 0.78, which equals 842 pixels, which will be our desired width for the surface. Together, we know that the resolution of the surface will be 842 by 1080. We can now enter this resolution when creating the surface inside QLab. But you may be asking, what if I have a surface that's not a rectangular shape? The calculations are the exact same as before, however, we need one extra step. First, we take the shape and we draw a rectangle around it, making sure that the whole shape fits inside. We then need to measure the dimensions of this resulting rectangle. For example, in my last video, I had a weird shape, and when I fit it into a rectangle, it measured 14 inches wide by 11 inches tall. I then used the math from above to find the proper surface resolution. If you like this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to check out my other videos on projection mapping. Also, if you have any suggestions for another video topic you would like to see covered here on the channel, leave it in the description below, and I will see you next time.